Morning, y'all. Well, we're trying to get us an early start this morning. Try to beat the heat. Sometime this morning, I'm expecting the service truck so I can pull out my radiator. It seemed like the machine was trying to run hot yesterday, so let's see if I can get ahead of that. It's got new air filters in it. It ain't because the air filters are clogged. Well, let's get started. I was working on the edge of this pond here and it got a little soft on me. So I got some of this debris and packed down there in the mud so I could walk on it. And I just wanted to take a minute to show y'all that. And remind you, anytime you get in an area and it gets soft, just take some of these tops or trash or whatever you're working with and stick it up under your tracks. You can go anywhere if you have the right kind of mat under you. You know, don't be shy to put a little extra, you know, push it, mash it down in there so you got a stable platform to work on. One thing to remember when you're taking down trees is to look for any power lines or hazards or potential damage to property nearby. Look for rotten limbs, broken tops, you know, rotten places in the tree, cankers, cat faces. Take all those things into consideration whenever you're taking down any trees. Now we're about to bust it up and get it in a pile. Well, we got it down and piled up.
Well, y'all are making some pretty good progress. You know, for it being just lunchtime. We did get started a little early this morning, around 6. You know, just to try to beat the heat. But it's lunchtime now, and we'll grab us a quick bite before we get back to it. Finish clearing onto this other side.
Wanted to take a minute and look at this patch they left here. This is our progress so far. Yeah, I just wanted to take a look before we dove in here head first and started pulling out utilities or something. There's got to be a reason they left this here. Got a power line overhead. I know about that. I see it's a little bit of fence in there. Okay. Left a couple of big trees here too. Got a couple of healthy ones. Power line right there. But what I'll do is I'll clean this out, get all this small stuff pulled out of there. I'll call and check on that fence and see if that's gonna be a big deal, because they're gonna be putting a new one in here. But I'll call anyway, and I don't want to upset anybody. All right, well, we'll get to it. Yeah, like I say, it's always good to step down off the Trackhoe and look at something, you know, put eyes on the whole job, because you never can tell what's on the other side of those trees. Like I say, you don't want to go in there and start pulling up utilities or put yourself in a dangerous situation that can be avoided. little recap on what we did today.
We started way down yonder this morning.
I had to leave these couple of trees right here because there was a gate, but we just took that down, so in the morning we'll tip them trees over. I'll dig on the backside of them and just get over here and push them over. And then we'll continue clearing on down along this side. Already started on there a little bit. Had to make a little dog leg there to get around the utility poles. But I'm up there on top of that hill now, and it's straight shot on down. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed today, and I appreciate you watching and subscribing and everything. I sure do.